On the bench today for the midweek buildup is AMT's 125th scale 1957 Thunderbird. It is a 3-in-1 kit, as you see. You can do convertible, hardtop, or a full-on custom ride with all the sweet parts in the box. They've got all kinds of stuff going on here. They got an engine stand. They got an all-chrome Thunderbird engine. They've got variable custom bezels. They've got a set of wheels in there. We've got the fastback top, the hardback top. Let's start cracking open the parts and see what we get inside. Be careful when you open the bags on these. Some of the parts were loose in mine, so keep an eye on that. You don't want to lose anything. First up will be this tree here with wheel rims, stock steering wheel, Continental spare tire cover, it looks like, and some custom body panels for some different types of wings and stuff. Might be stock body panels too. I got to take a look at that. There's a lot of stuff in the kit. On here, we've got an engine block and transmission and manifolds. We've got our spare tire cover. We've got our optional Continental rear bumper there with the spare tire. We've got our wheel blocks, as I call them, the axle blocks, and then we've got our engine stand over here. We've got our heater. We've got an optional phone for the car. Remember when car phones actually looked just like real phones? Then on this tree, we've got our fastback top, which is really cool looking. If you look on the box art, that's cool. Like, I like that design. That's interesting. I wonder if I can mix and match. I don't want to do full-on custom, but like this, but just with that fat, I don't know, we'll see. So we've got our interior tub here, which on this one is just the seats and the floor pan. Then we've got a separate dash and door panel area right there with heavy detail on the dash. Fastback top, like I said, we've got some wheel skirts, wheel skirts. Then we've got our convertible top. We've got our hood, this little built-in hood scoop. Underneath looks nice. Got all the webbing and everything for the air cleaner. I have no idea what this part is. Extra part that's not particularly used for this kit, you can tell me in the comments. I like learning. And then we've got this large piece of plastic in the model, large piece of styrene. I haven't seen it referenced in the instruction manual. Got our chassis here. Cross member, differential, drive shaft, and exhaust all built in. We'll take some hand painting with a thin brush. Fuel tank, suspension, all molded in. These are where those axle blocks will go. We'll glue them in. We'll put our axles through. That's the top, so this will be our inner fenders. We'll get all that painted. And then we've got the Thunderbird body set up as a convertible out of the mold, but of course you can change that with your custom parts. Firewall, inner fenders, all built in. Nice detail on those. They've got the battery in there. They got reservoir tank. They even got the radiator in that. That's pretty amazing. So nice detail on that. Nice detail on the body. Got our vents, got our Thunderbird logo. Door panels are very shallow. Very shallow. You might want to scribe those open. Yeah. Super shallow on the molding on that. We got our nice door handles are crisp though. We can always dig in if you so choose and deepen the molding on the trunk. So now let's go to the other side of the table. We've got one. We've got two entire sets of tires, custom wider Goodyears, black wall on the other side for people that aren't a fan of the brand, and then a nice tread pattern, an entire set of hollow Goodyears. You always got lots of tires in the AMTs. White wall Firestones, labeled Firestones on the black wall side, bias ply tread, gorgeous pad printing on those white walls. Always looks great, just like the box art on there. We've got two steel axles. We've got a chrome tree here with the engine and manifolds on it. Air cleaner, intake. I don't think you have enough. I didn't see enough to build two complete engines because we only got one distributor, one belt and pulley system, Thunderbird valve covers. So I think we're supposed to build the chrome engine and the other engine parts are left over for something else. You'll have a spare block, transmission, manifolds. We've got our glass for all the different options. Windshield, fastback, convertible top. Got our headlights there, don't forget those. Nice and clear. You can see the name of the show through there. And we've got a final chrome tree with one, two, three entire sets of wheels. I like those custom ones on there. Those are a custom look on there. And that is a cool look in the black with the fastback and all that. We'll have to check that out. Got our windshield frame. Be very, very careful with this. Mine is not damaged. So be very careful when you're detaching that. We got our shifter. Chrome trim for around the optional spare tire. I'm pretty sure that part is that right there. Around the top of that spare tire. And then we've got our grill. Black wash inside there will look lovely. And that's it, folks. That's all the parts. Now in the instruction manual, they do tell you which you can use for the decals that we're going to look at in a second. But check out the custom options you have. Got all these Thunderbird logos and flames. Those are coming up. So that decal guide is in there. You can see that the optional spare tire cover. But in here, all I see is one build for an engine. I don't see two engine builds in there at all. I see the engine stand. I see locate the assembled engine, but I don't see anything in here referencing being able to build two complete engines. So I don't want you to think that when you look at the parts. The decals are right here and they are beautiful. We've got some wildfowl logos. We've got white flames. We'll get the reflection off that background. White flames. We've got two complete sets of gauges. Stock, custom. All the Thunderbird logos you can handle. Stock Thunderbird logos, which are always important on the builds. I like having them. Four license plates. Boomin' Bird. All the boomers out there. Nice set. Big sheet of decals on there. Now I'm going to get to gluing my Thunderbird together. I'll have to decide what I want to do with it. And I'll see you in just a moment. Thank you. a very straightforward assembly process, nothing much to look at. I did glue what you can get together of the second engine block and transmission. You of course have those manifolds left over as well, but all the parts are used to build the chrome engine as detailed in the instruction manual, so that's what I did. So this is what you would have left, and those manifolds and some other stuff on the chrome tree. We've got the fans super glued to the belt and pulley system. That's what you saw me using. In the little red bottle is just dollar store super glue. And what you saw me adding with the pipette when I was working on the engine is super glue activator, which you can get anywhere. And it just makes the super glue dry even faster so you can move on. So looking at that engine, it's a little hard to see everything when they're in chrome like that. But we've got our manifolds attached, our intake carburation is one piece, we've got our cylinder heads, our distributor, and our water pump and oil filler, so don't break that off. And on the intake, make sure that the pointy end faces forward so you can attach the coolant line. Got our oil pan on there. I thought Ford's had the oil pans reversed, but the instructions on this one say to have it like this, so I'm sure some had it like this in the older days or whatever, whenever they decided to change things or however they do it. But that's your assembled engine, and it looks nice. Like I said, it's hard to see a lot of it in chrome, but we'll get that painted and all set up. I also assembled the engine stand for you so you can see how that turns out. We've seen this in quite a few other models. We've got our chrome tree here with our options for the wheels. If you had extra steel axles, you might be able to swap out wheel and tire packages on this model. I mean, we've got everything we need to do what we need with the kit. So, got our wheel bags here. We can paint those up. We've got our heater blower. We've got our radiator shroud. Those are the custom bezels. And then our phone. So we can paint this tree up on its own, get it on there, along with the radiator hose for that upper radiator. We've got our hood, which you can attach your custom hood scoop to. If you want, you can leave it as is. Got our interior bucket. I just cut that off so I can hold on to it, spray it, get my color in the dash, which I'll actually try to hand paint that, and then leave the upper and lower areas the color that I choose. We've got our chassis with our axle blocks installed all the way around. Steering wheel I cut off so that I can just hold it here with my clips and spray paint it. We've got our hard top, the convertible top. We've got our optional spare tire carrier. Whether I'm probably going to paint this and see how it looks on it, see how it looks off. But I wanted to put it together for you so you can check it out. And then I've got the Fastback. What it seems like is once we get the windshield in place, we can just paint these up as we wish and interchange them. I mean, they don't really mount. I suppose if you wanted to glue one, you could, but you don't have to. And it fits along the body nicely. That windshield frame is going to fall off because I don't have any of that glued. But it seems like we can do that without much of an issue. I cut out the windshield frame to show you, if you take your time gently cutting it out, you won't damage it and it will still look nice. We're going to have to attach our glass inside here. So that'll be a small process with some Mod Podge and cleaning it up with a wet Q-tip. Then we've got our body, which required no work. What you don't see on here are the wheel skirts. I know they even have them on the custom one. I don't like them. And if I had a car with them on, they would be pulled off and put on a shelf in the garage. I'm not a fan of them, so they're not going on my model. But they are available. You can glue them in place if you so choose. I'm not going to be using them. I want to see my full wheel and tire package when I cruise. I always think wheel skirts make it look like your rear suspension, like you've got three people hiding in the trunk. So not a fan of them, not going to use them on my builds. And you can if you wish, and they look real nice on a lot of cars. I just don't prefer them. I'm going to start painting everything right now. We're going to get some work done on the car. We're going to do our tops, our interior, and then we'll go on to the detail section. Hello all you cool cats and kittens. We've got the Thunderbird here. I'm doing the Fastback. I also did the hardtop so we can see it that way. Did them in different colors. Now, since I'm gonna be going with the Fastback, when I put the car together, I don't think I'll be using the Continental, the big spare, but I did glue it all together. I did paint it in the body color and I put the chrome trim on it so that you could see what it would look like when it's assembled. If we put it on the back of the car, it would slide in right underneath into there. And you'll see what it looks like. We'll turn the body a little bit. So it would look quite nice. I'm just not gonna be putting it on the Fastback. It doesn't make much sense. With the custom, the air would hit the spare tire and stuff like that. But it does look nice. It goes together easy, and that's why I wanted to show it to you. I've got the little chrome model car that's included on one of the chrome parts trees. So don't miss that. That's actually like, looks like kind of a little Fastback version of it. It's definitely a Fastback, but yeah. So that's neat to have there. And then it's also got this cool chrome Thunderbird logo right there. So you get some little extra doodads. You got the motor stand and everything if you want to use it. And don't forget those spare tires all set up there and all the wheels. So we've got the rear bumper all set. You can see I blacked out on the bumper there. We've got our front grille and bumper assembly. Now, it maybe not have been orange back in the day, but since it's a customized car, I oranged out the turn signals because I think it'll look good with that smolder color. Two-tone interior. I did the dash in the equestrian, the seats in the khaki, and then just over the seats, you can see all the carpets just a shade lighter. I just misted some of the equestrian over the khaki so it wasn't such a sharp contrast, but a nice two-tone. Put the tachometer on there for the steering wheel. You don't have to add that, but I did. Put the gauge in there and hand-painted the door panels and the dashboard since it was such a deep engraving. Got our shifter in there. That's going to look great, and that will just slide up inside the body. There's two posts underneath there. We've got our Fastback top. No issues with that. Glued in the glass. No problem at all putting that one together. So that's set to go. Same with our convertible top. We can get it. The windshield's not glued on yet, of course. But with the white, that looks nice too. So we can go back and forth. They sit on there. They line up nicely, so we don't really have to glue anything in place. The windshield, I did clamp it together and glued everything with Mod Podge. And then on the bottom of the glass, though, even though it did fit nice and it fits the shape, so I know it had the correct way, we still had some overhang, and I didn't want that. Now, I think some of that overhang is to hold it in position where it is. So I left it the lip underneath the windshield wipers. That I left. But on this side, I did trim it flat with my sprue cutter just to make sure we didn't have any interference or anything that would cause the windshield to pop free after we did it. But that's about where it'll go, and now it sits in place better with the glass, and the Mod Podge holds it in. And if you make a mistake with Mod Podge, you just lick the Q-tip and wipe it off. If you make a mistake with model cement, then for clear parts, you're up you know what creek. We got the body ready to go, got our headlights in. I used a silver marker behind the headlights, then put future floor polish inside the hole and stuck the glass in there. Got our hood on. You saw how I did the hood scoop. That looks pretty tight in there. Did our trim on our fins. Used a black marker to outline the door panels all the way around and the trunk lid. Just did the red Tamiya clear and then pushed the taillights in place. They fit nice and tight. And that's all for those parts. And then our chassis, I'm using those custom Goodyears. I really like them. I ended up not knowing what I wanted to do with this car. I was going to do it as a traditional Thunderbird, and then when I saw this picture, that just looked too tough to me with those gold, you know, those flames and stuff. That was just really, really tough looking. So minus the wheel skirts, we're going to be setting it up that way. Got the engine set up with the Thunderbird valve covers. That's all ready to go. Did very, very minor detailing underneath. Just did the exhaust quick. Got those sweet mag wheels with the Goodyears on them. They look really, really tight. And that's it. I've got to put like the radiator shroud in under the hood. I already painted the battery and the radiator. The tank here I have to do, the reservoir pocket for the windshield washer, I just have to do in red. And yeah, very basic detailing. I have to attach the heater motor, the cowling over the radiator. Once the car's intact, this will just go like that. Sorry, I need to actually put it in camera. That'll just go like that over the top. Not gonna have any issues. It's gonna look pretty cool. So we'll see how it all goes together. The air cleaner has a nice big stud for the top of that carburetor. That'll just press into place and be chrome as well on the custom rod. So I'm gonna get working on all of that. I gotta put my decals on. Decide when I'm not gonna be doing the full decal package, but I am gonna be replicating some of the box art on mine. I will put a coat or two of future floor polish on the entire model, both of the tops, the windshield, everything, and then we'll have that final. With this is the final of the 1957 Ford Thunderbird 125th scale 3-in-1 custom from AMT. Now, a lot of times I just go and build it completely stock and enjoy it, but box art can always inspire you. They got lots of good ideas, and definitely that rig there is what I somewhat duplicated on my final build here. We got it all set up. I did only use some of the flame decals. They are just a white silhouette. I used it on the roof for the Fastback, and I used it on the fenders. Did a little bit of chrome striping, got our bumpers to fit in, used the Thunderbird license plate, the Thunderbird logos on the hood, and the fender trim, which all look amazing. They look wonderful. So the headlights went in easy, the engine goes into the chassis easy, the wheels and tires fit perfectly on each other. We didn't have any issues with the wheels being floppy or not fitting on the steel axles. Everything went together great, and now we have a really cool looking Fastback. But if we want to change it out, we remove the Fastback roof with the cool striping on it. We see that awesome two-tone equestrian and khaki interior. And remember, this is spinning, so it's a little difficult to get it on there. But we could put the white top on there and make it look really cool, because it's got the white flame striping, it's got the white glossy top. I mean, it really does go together. Either way you do it on this ride is going to look just fine. And you have those options, and then you can take the top completely off and see inside. And I got the little metal car in there down there. And, you know, the windshield fits in, the interior pops into the body quite easily. We can open the hood at any time and take a look. I can't get my finger in there. It's a really tight seam. You almost have to flip the car and tap it over. But yeah, so you can do that. You can plop that Fastback top right back on there. So if you don't want to permanently join it, it still looks cool. I didn't even know the Fastback thing was an option for the Thunderbird customization and all that. And it looks pretty funky built up like that. So I enjoyed the kit immensely, way more than I thought I would. I thought it was just going to be a regular Thunderbird build. And then the box art was just like, hey man, make it look completely different. Give it a custom paint job. Do whatever you want with it. And that's what I did. And that wheel and tire package looks totally mean. I mean, the white walls look great on a Thunderbird, but this just looks tough. This would be, you know, the kid bought it from grandpa and grandma when they got rid of driving around their sports car, and he just kind of went nuts with it in like the late 60s. You know, it was already 12 years old, and he went crazy with it to keep up with all the other Mopar guys and Ford guys that were getting real muscle cars. So I enjoyed the build. It was way easier than I thought. I thought that separate windshield frame would be fiddly. I thought I'd have problems with that two-piece interior, and it actually worked out extremely well and gave me some options and ideas and some fun stuff to do. The engine is more than detailed enough. Glues right into the chassis. Of course, the chassis itself is not extremely detailed. I mean, you saw me hand paint on there. It's pretty basic, but with some painting and some shadowing, if you wanted to dry brush that chassis and stuff, you'd have something look pretty darn sweet. I enjoyed it. I recommend it. I will link down into the description so that when it is available, you can get your pre-orders in. As I said, the decals went down beautifully. Look how the Thunderbird logos and the Thunderbird script sink in to the raised scripts on the side of the car with a little decal solvent. They just went right in and they look 3D now. I loved it. Super fast build. about 8 hours invested into this build total over a couple days while I worked on other stuff. So yeah, you're gonna have a good time with this no matter how you decide to build it. As always, I wanna thank Round 2 Models for sending the kit over for review. I enjoyed it, I had fun. There was no issues with assembly or fit on anything. And as always, I like your comments, suggestions, and hints in the comment section of the video. I will see all of you at the next review.